All right, what is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justice. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and also like the video, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so every time that I drop a new video, you all can stay notified. And within this video, I'm going to be showing you all how to create a Instagram story frame for your music videos. And, you know, I'm gonna give you the dimensions, you know, what all you need to do pretty much. It's just gonna be like a tutorial overall. So the things that you would need within this video, or to create a, an Instagram story template for your music videos, you would need Photoshop, and you will also need Final Cut Pro X or Final Cut Pro 10, whatever you wanna call it. And we're gonna go ahead and hop into it. And the music video template that I'm gonna be remaking is a music video that I shot for my guy Mo C. The music video was named Ghost. So if you haven't watched that already, make sure you go watch it. It's on my channel and it's also on his. Before I hop into the music video, I wanna show you all a new purchase that I made, man. You know, the solid DJI Mavic Air. I also have a video coming soon on it. I'm pretty much editing it now. So it should be coming out very soon, within the next 2 weeks, or possibly by the beginning of April or whatever. So yeah, I just wanted to show you all that. I may overlay some B-roll and some pictures of it that I've captured recently. That I always wanted to get. The only thing that I can say so far that I'm noticing, I believe that I need to go ahead and get an ND filter. I know a lot of people were saying that you don't necessarily need one unless you're like taking it, not necessarily serious, but unless you're doing professional work. But I have noticed that I'm seeing like a lot of, I think they're called zebra lines and stuff in my footage, and like just unnecessary like jitters and stuff. And I believe it's just because my shutter speed is off. So I believe once I get the ND filter, it'll help, you know, overall with the footage, allowing me to, you know, maximize my shutter speed, doubling it by my, the proper shutter roll and stuff. But anyways, yeah, let's go ahead and hop into this video. So I'm already screen recording my screen and stuff. I got the mic going. And also, you know, obviously my fans are going to speed up on my laptop. So if you hear that, that's pretty much why. So let's go ahead and hop into this video or whatever. So I'm going ahead and create new. We're going to call this IG story. I can't spell IG story frame. And then I chose the wrong framing, which is cool. We're gonna make a new one. All right, so what you want to do is you want to go ahead and give the right measurements, which is 1080 by 1920. That's overall the measurements for Instagram stories. So you want to go ahead and type that in here, 1080 by 1920, and click the check mark. And then next, what you want to do is, actually I need to grab something from, all right, so yeah, like I was saying, you want to go ahead and get the right measurements for your Instagram story template. And what you want to do is next, you want to go ahead and drag in your screenshots that you got from the music video or whatever you're using. You could be taking a photo and using it for that instance, but in this case I'm going to be using screenshots from the music video that I've done. And you want to put one at the top, and you also want to put the other one at the bottom, right? So the next thing that you want to do is you want to use your eraser tool, and you want to pick one. Obviously this is one of my favorite ones. You can go to a website named Brush Easy to get brush effects. So if you get this little error, pretty much it's not allowing you to use your brushes, what you want to do is you want to go down, hold down on the image, and then go down to rasterize layer, and that should allow you to use it. This is too big, so I'm gonna go ahead and shrink that down a little bit. And then let's erase the bottom half of this first one. Like I said before, rasterize the layer, and then it should allow you to use your eraser tool. So pretty much what you're doing is you're taking off the top and bottom to give it like I like the torn paper effect. That's pretty much what it is to me. And it kind of get rid of those harsh lines, like giving it an effect, pretty much like a brush effect. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spin this one around because that's taking off too much of the image in my opinion. So I'm gonna spin it around and then it should be flipped, allowing me to just take off that top portion. So now what you wanna do is you wanna go ahead and bring in your text. Like I said, the guy name was Mosey that I did the music video for. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in that. Let me change this color to white. And also shrink this down because it's extremely too big. Let's go with maybe 20. That's too small. Let's go with 30 is cool. Rock with 30. Put that about here. And now what you want to do is you want to put the name of the song, which is GOAT. And then we're probably going to make this a lot smaller, maybe about 10. And then what you want to do is you want to space it out, the letters out a little bit to give it a better, more effect, I think. I think it gives it like a cool effect. Then center that with the artist name, right, so that's looking solid. And now, well, actually that's not, framing isn't right in my opinion. I'm gonna actually space out the letters in his name a bit. And then drag it over a little bit to center up with that. All right, that looks a little bit better. Still could be a little bit less. A 100 is cool, I think. And also my fans are speeding up. I'm not sure, I think I did mention that, but yeah, my fans are speeding up because I'm kind of doing a lot now. All right, so now you see the artist name and the music video title, which is GOAT, and the artist name is Mosey. All right, so next what you want to do is you want to obviously put who the music video was shot by, which would be you, the director, or either, you know, just put shot by or directed by. Usually I put directed by because I'm the person that's either, I'm the person usually telling the artist what to do in movements, and we both kind of go off each other's minds and stuff like that. So I usually drag in my directed by title. Or actually, I drag that in. I already have this kind of set to where I don't have to type it in every time. I usually want to put it in the same side that the artist's, you know, name is, which up under would be, you know, on the side over here. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna probably put it on this side. And then change the color to black. Oh, not darken. I guess we're gonna scroll through into the term. Okay, so subtract is actually what turns it black. All right, and now what you wanna do is you wanna put your actual name, which mine is Justice. So I wanna drag that in and, you know, make it a decent size so people can actually see who your name is or what your name is. And turn this one to subtract as well. Okay, so now you get a gist of what exactly it looks like. So, you know, you got the artist name, Mosey, and you got the title of the music video, which is GOAT. And then you also have, you know, who the music video was directed by. It looks pretty solid. And you can always change the colors or whatever you want it to be, but I usually either stick with black or white just so it doesn't, you know, get too crazy and distracting. So after you got that done, you want to get rid of this background, which is white. And then the most biggest step, in my opinion, that you want to do is... full screen. What you want to do is you want to hit file, export as, and then you want to make the format a PNG. If you don't make it a PNG, you won't be able to fit your music video in there. It'll pretty much still be that white background. So once you delete that white background and put PNG, you'll be straight. Your music video will be solid to go right in the center of, you know, your music video template. So you hit export and then you want to name it or whatever. So I'm gonna put IG story frame. I don't know why I put it in all caps, but IG story frame vid and then I'm gonna hit save, right? It's gonna save to my desktop. It shouldn't take long at all. And then I'm gonna minimize that, minimize my voice audio or whatever. And then it's right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to Final Cut Pro. I'm going to go to File once it's full screen. All right, I'm gonna go to Final Cut Pro. My laptop is lagging a little bit. I'm gonna go to File, New Project, and then I'm gonna go to Custom. And then I'm gonna change the resolution to 1080 by 1920. And then keep the frame rate 24 frames per second pretty much. Then you hit okay. So pretty much this is still giving you the same exact framing, or you know, the dimensions of the Instagram story. So then I'm gonna minimize this again, and then I'm gonna go ahead and drag in my frame template. I know some of you probably are thinking like, why isn't this dude hitting File and opening the, you know, the project or whatever. This is just how I edit, man. Since it's already be on my desktop, I just find it's a lot easier. So then what I'm gonna do is drag in the music video as well, which should be here. That's definitely gonna take a little bit of time to render in. Oh, I guess not. Okay, so now what you wanna do is you want to, I usually put the template over the music video and then drag it out, pretty much extend it as long as the music video is or whatever. And then what you want to do is you want to scale the music video up, because obviously it's not fitting. You can still see these black lines and stuff, right? So what you want to do is you want to scale up the music video to where the black lines aren't showing anymore. And then what you want to do is choose your favorite part of the music video. Let me put my headphones back on because you can hear what the heck is going on, not in the audio. So yeah, once you have your music video framed exactly inside the two photos, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and choose your favorite part of the music video. So right here, we'll go ahead and cut both of these clips and then delete that. Okay, we can't look sad. Take a sip of that rumity rum. All right, so that was my favorite part of the music video. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut after this part where he say G-O-A-T, one under the sun, right? Okay, funny fact about this music video, all the B-roll that I did, I didn't even slow it down. I forgot while I was editing it. This is something I forgot to do. But yeah, so after you chose your favorite part, usually Instagram stories are about, I believe 15 seconds. So you want to make it roughly 15 seconds. Or you can make it 30, whatever the framing or timing you want to make it. So after you get it to about 15 seconds, you want to cut that. And then once you have it exactly at 15 seconds, you want to play it back. And that's pretty much overall what you get. If it's not framed right, you can always go to your, I believe it's your x-axis. Yeah, you want to go to your x-axis and then, you know, center it properly or whatever. But given that it's quite framed right, in my opinion, that's pretty much overall what you want to do. And as you export it from Final Cut Pro X, you want to hit export, and then you want to go to settings and then change your video codecs to the H.264. That's pretty much the already compressed version of your video, so it doesn't get extra compressed as you post it to your Instagram story or Instagram feed. And you know, you export it out and then hit, you know, title it whatever you want to title it. I'm gonna put IG story again, frame, vid, hit save, let that export. It shouldn't take long at all because it's only a 15 second video. Once that export, you have it, you post it to your Instagram story, and that's pretty much what you get. And that's pretty much it, y'all, man. It was pretty simple. And that's going to wrap up this video, man. If you enjoyed it, make sure to like it. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And that's going to wrap it up. I'll see you all in the next one. My name is Justice, and peace out, guys.